So for FPGA gaming and your rechargeable devices, will rechargeable zinc ion batteries
replace other rechargeable batteries?
Stand back, I'm gonna do some science and find out.
Batteries. The original Game Boy was designed to be a power sipper with a non-backlit LCD screen and a power-sipping CPU, allowing it to get roughly 30 hours of battery life. But you have to play it in a well-lit room and have the angle just right to have it be usable. But now, with all these new FPGA-based Game Boy clones on the market with bright IPS LCD screens, battery life has taken on a whole new meaning. This is especially true with the ModRetro Chromatic, which takes AA batteries. So the big question is, for AA-powered devices, which rechargeable battery is best? The old standby, rechargeable nickel metal hydride, or the newcomer, rechargeable Nickel-Zinc? I'm gonna run a series of tests and find out with measurable data. I'm feeling pretty positive about this experiment, so let's see if there are any negatives. Now, here's how I'm gonna test them. I set up a time-lapse camera to run overnight, shooting a whopping 3 frames a second. All Game Boy compatible systems will be running Tetris DX at a full brightness because it has a colorful looping demo that closely resembles gameplay. To set a baseline, I'm going to test the Analogue Pocket, the FunnyPlaying FPGBC, and both use lithium-ion rechargeable batteries. My hypothesis is that watching tiny Tetris blocks drop for hours and hours on end is slightly more interesting than watching paint dry, but we'll see if the data supports that. The folks over at SciGold sent me their rechargeable Nickel-Zinc batteries, along with their rechargeable nickel-metal hydride batteries to put them to the test. They also sent their battery charger for this review. I was immediately impressed with the charger. It doesn't plug into the wall, instead it charges via USB-C. It also has a really cool display that shows the charge for each battery, and it can automatically tell if you've inserted a nickel-zinc or nickel-metal hydride battery. I was initially skeptical about the charger, but it won me over. I really got a charge out of this thing. Testing methodology. My first test subject is the Analogue Pocket. It has a proprietary rechargeable lithium-ion battery that is 4,300 milliamp hours, and I'm going to run that down from fully charged at maximum brightness, but with the sound turned off to keep things consistently playing Tetris DX for Game Boy Color running in the open FPGA core. I ran this test alongside a FunnyPlaying FPGBC with its own 1800 milliamp hour lithium ion rechargeable battery running Tetris DX on the EverDrive GBX7 at maximum brightness and with the volume turned down for comparison. And for a baseline AA battery test, I ran the ModRetro Chromatic FPGA video game system with some Mega Evil Online bookstore brand nickel metal hydride batteries on a full charge. I set my video output in OBS to a blistering 3 frames a second so I could shoot the time-lapse footage without filling up my SSD. So which battery will come out on top? Let's find out. The Analogue Pocket lasted 4 hours, 16 minutes, and 44 seconds. And it's officially out of juice. I guess you can say its time in the sun was pocket-sized. Now, it has a pretty big battery, but with that huge high-resolution screen, it just uses a lot of power. So the lesson from this is that it's best to turn the brightness down a little bit so you can be a little kinder on your battery and your eyes. FunnyPlaying FPGBC, 5 hours, 59 minutes, and 57 seconds. That is quite reasonable. The FunnyPlaying FPGBC lasted basically 6 hours. That is pretty respectable. And finally, the Chromatic with bookstore brand batteries lasted 7 hours, 33 minutes, and 22 seconds. Very, very respectable. So after the baseline was set, it was time for the main event. The next day, I charged up my SciGold nickel metal hydride batteries and ran the same test. And after an incredible 7 hours, 36 minutes, and 20 seconds, the lights went out. But winner, winner, chicken dinner. These beat the online bookstore brand nickel metal hydride batteries, and you can literally run the Chromatic F Game Boy Color compatible system at full brightness for 7 hours and 36 minutes. Finally, it was time to test the zinc batteries. Now, these have a higher voltage output. Nickel-zinc cells have a nominal voltage of 1.6 volts, which is closer to the 1.5 volts of the standard alkaline non-rechargeable battery. This can be beneficial for certain electronic devices that are sensitive to voltage and might not perform optimally with the lower 1.2 volts out of the Ni-MH batteries. So I am very interested to see how that translates into real-world FPGA battery life. The Chromatic with nickel-zinc AA batteries, 5 hours, 24 minutes, and 19 seconds. Well, it played for 5 hours and 24 minutes, and that is still a pretty darn long time. The strengths of zinc. And the bottom line is, there are plenty of other reasons to prefer zinc here. They're much safer than lithium-ion batteries, period. They're also cheaper and they're more sustainable because they don't rely on expensive rare materials. So you get a battery that not only works perfectly in a portable analog cassette player due to its voltage, but it's also just a more responsible choice. So it's funny, the reasons are the same reasons it's the ideal drop-in battery for something classic and analog like this. Rechargeable nickel metal hydride batteries continue to reign supreme and had some very good results in the Chromatic. I was impressed to see that the Chromatic outlasted both FPGA Game Boy systems when playing Game Boy Color games, and it did so by an hour and a half. The FunnyPlaying FPGBC was no slacker, and the battery drain on the Analogue Pocket was probably due to its big and bright screen. So, rechargeable nickel-zinc batteries performed comparable to the FPGBC and still beat the Analogue Pocket. For longevity, you sure can't beat the nickel-metal hydride batteries. Anyway, this was a fun video to make. I'm a big nerd, and I love reproducible empirical data.
So, we make videos like this each week, and there are some really cool ones coming up, so you should totally click that subscribe button so you don't miss out. Thanks for watching. This is 8-Bit Joystick. Stay awesome. Play retro.